everyone, it's Jen, and I'm here today to do a flip through and a giveaway for the brand new coloring book by Masja Vandenberg. This is called Masja's Mandalas Spring, and you may remember that I also showed her first mandala book that came out sometime last year, and Masja contacted me again and asked me if I would like to show this and do a giveaway on my channel. So I said absolutely, because she is a wonderful artist to work with. I really like working with artists that are kind to the people that produce videos and Instagram posts and things like that. So I accepted right away, and we're going to be flipping through this and looking at it, and then I will be telling you about the giveaway that we're going to do. So Masja provided a brand new copy for one of you, and it is signed, so you'll be getting a brand new signed copy of this gorgeous book. I've kept this in the wrapping since I got it. I actually got it quite a while ago, but I've been working on some pictures so that I would have some things done in the book while we do the flip through. So we're going to flip through my book, and my book is signed as well. Now, these are printed on white, single-sided, perforated pages. So it's very nice. They are cardstock-like pages. They are very thick. I still would put something in between if you are going to do alcohol markers, just because there is a good chance that it will go through. But our first mandala is flowers and butterflies and the adorable little kitty. So, so cute. I love this picture. It's one of my favorites in the book, and somehow still I haven't done it. I don't know. I always do that kind of thing where I really love a picture and I end up not coloring it right away. I end up coloring other things first. I don't know why that always happens to me, but for some reason it does. So I do need to get around to doing the kitty, because I have a vision for that one. So mixed in with like the animals and the spring scenes and things like that, we have traditional mandalas, and some of them are more intricate than others. So you get a nice mix of different things to work on in the book. And if you are on Instagram and you've followed Masja, she does post a lot of people's work if they tag her in it, and there is some gorgeous work in these books. People creating their own scenes to go with the mandalas and all her other pictures and stuff is truly, truly remarkable. I love seeing that kind of work, because I'm not artistic in that way where I could like create another scene. I'm okay at coloring a picture, but creating something else is not really my bag. So, yeah. This is another one that I want to color, and I just love it. I just haven't decided if I want to just do gel pens on it, or if I want to do watercolors, or what I want to do, but isn't that so cute? I adore these. They are so cute, and they're so different. It's not just like your traditional, typical mandala. I really was never into coloring mandalas, and then I got Masja's first book, and I worked on one that was like a dream catcher, and I absolutely loved it. I only worked with pencils, and I had so much fun doing it. It really got me into doing them a little bit more often. So clearly I worked on this one. I used the Arteza pencils, a little bit of polychromos, some fine tech watercolors on the leaves, and some glitter gel pen. And it was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed working on it. It's a sweet little spring picture. And this is kind of like, to me, it looks like a butterfly mandala. I really like this one. I definitely need to get in there with some glitter gel pens and just glitter that bad boy up. I just haven't had a whole lot of time, not as much time as I used to color, so that's why I haven't gotten as many done as I would have liked to by this time. But I wanted to go ahead and show you the book and actually get the giveaway going for you guys, because I've had it for a while and I've been talking about it, so I wanted to get this up. This is such a cool one. Look at the bug inside there. So the bug is totally like wrapped around inside the mandala. And what you could do, I mean, like, I think what I would do is make the background of the scene kind of like pastel-y, because that's usually how I do my colors, or really kind of like dull, and then make the bug stick out. Or you could do the opposite, and then either way the bug is going to stick out once you start coloring the stuff around it. But I think that one's really cool. Here you have some hearts, and it looks like some flowers and leaves. So pretty. And they are so, I don't know, they're nice and big, so they're nice to color. This was the first one that I did. I've shown it before, so you may have seen it if you've watched one of my older videos, but I used Arteza pencils and glitter gel pen on this, and I had so much fun doing this one. It was just, I don't know, it was just really relaxing and nice, and when I looked at it first, I was like, I don't know how I'm gonna do this, but somehow it just kind of worked its way out, and I really enjoyed working on it. And here's a more traditional one. There's a lot of little things to color in this one. So this would be good with like your gel pens, I think, for sure, or your fine liners. I've seen this one done a lot on Instagram, and I think it's so cute. It's like a little deer or a lamb or whatever you want it to be. Mine probably won't be a traditional color. I usually like to make my things different colors, but I think it's so cute and fun to color. This one's like not too crazy. This can keep you, like, if you're watching TV, you can just like watch TV and then come back and do it. And there's not like too much to be involved with if that's what you're looking for. I love this one. This one's so different. This is the fireflies breaking away. Fireflies or dragonflies breaking away from the mandala. Just different, really something different than you normally see. A really great idea. And I mean, you could totally glitter this one up. You could like put some chalk in the background to make it really stand out and stuff. Really, really beautiful. This one's like crazy detailed. There's a lot to color. So if you like that kind of thing, this would definitely be one for you. Really beautiful. And here you have one with the little bees. I really like this one too. This one's super cute. Really beautiful. I'll probably do some watercolors on this one. And that is it. That is the end of the book. There is the lovely Masja. So I want to just take a moment and thank Masja so much for sending me a copy of this. This is her first mandala book. I do have a flip through on my channel if you want to check it out. I will leave the link down below to her Etsy store, but here is the information if you wanted to order a copy of this book for yourself. She also has, as I said, this mandala, and she has a beautiful coloring book. I believe it was one of her first ones called From Holland with Love, and I have that one, and I love it. That was my very first book of hers. So we're going to talk about the giveaway now. So what we're going to do is this is going to be open as soon as this video goes live. So this will be up. It should be up tonight, which is August 5th. And it is going to run for 2 weeks. So it'll close on August 19th at midnight Eastern Standard Time. So if you do not have your comment in by 11:59, excuse me, if you don't have your comment in by midnight Eastern Standard Time on, let's say, the 19th, 20th, so the 19th going into the 20th. That's it. That's the cutoff date. So anytime after midnight, no more comments will count after that time. So all you have to do to enter is you have to be a subscriber of my channel, and you have to leave a comment down below. And in your comment down below, I want to know what picture you think you would color first if you were to win the book. So in order to win, you have to be 18 years or older or have your parents' permission in order to receive a package from me. This is open internationally, so anybody can enter. It will be sent directly from me, so you don't have to worry about anything like that. You just have to make sure that you are okay with receiving a package from me and be okay with giving me your address. Let's see, anything else? I think that's it. That's all that I have to tell you. It's open till August 19th at midnight, then the contest will close and no more comments will be accepted. If you comment twice, you will be disqualified. Please make sure you leave your own comment and you do not comment on someone else's comment. If you comment on someone else's comment, it does not count as an entry for yourself. I hope that you will enter this. I hope that you will go check out Masja's Etsy store. And again, I just want to thank Masja so much for always thinking of me and reaching out to me and providing a copy for the Reading with Pugs viewers. And that's it. So, oh, one more thing. If you, once I pick the winner, what I'll do is I'll count up all the entries. I will put them into random.org and then I will have them pick a number. Once I pick the number, what I do is I contact the winner by leaving a comment under their comment. So I will put a heart, I will like love the comment, the little heart thing, and then I will comment and say, you are the winner, please contact me, and I'll leave the information on where you should contact me. So please make sure you have your emails and all those kinds of things set up so that you can receive a comment back from me on YouTube. I will wait 48 hours. If the person does not contact me within 48 hours, I'll pick a new winner. So that's it. That now I'm done. That's all I have to tell you. So thank you so much for watching today. And I will see you in my next video.